All right, what is going on, guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, back with another Dokkan Battle video, and today we are going to be taking on the transformation boost stage of Super Battle Road with my brand spanking new STR Transforming Cooler. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I am like super, super happy that I actually managed to pull this guy in my first video, no less, which is something that just never happens to me, you know? Like, I don't remember the last time I've wanted a unit this bad, and it took me less than 2 to 3 videos and 500 to 1,000 stones minimum to pull the one copy. And there's been times where I've spent like 3,000 stones and still it wasn't enough to pull even one copy of the unit I wanted, namely the AGL LR Gohan and the LR Androids. So yeah, I've definitely experienced my fair share of massive shafts in the past, but not this time. All right, this time your boy got blessed. We pulled the cooler in the first video. And with all that said, let's get down to the summons right now. Wait, did I say summons? Let's get into this run right now. Obviously, I still have summoning on the brain. I still want to go back in for the dupe, but I just feel like it's a really, really bad idea. I'll think about it though. Think about it. Right now, let's focus on Super Battle Road and then maybe some summons later on. No promises, but this is the team, guys. Pretty freaking solid if you ask me, especially if you compare it to the previous team that I used to beat this event. It was the Artificial Lifeforms team led by an LR Baby, because at the time I didn't even have a proper transformation boost leader. So the LR Baby worked, but I just felt like it was a lot harder, a lot more difficult than it had to be. And now with the double coolers, with the proper transformation boost leads, I think this event should be a breeze. Although I probably should shut up right now just in case, you know, I struggle or die. It's still Super Battle Road, so anything could happen. So yeah, I'm gonna chill for a bit. Let's just focus on doing our best here. And we have a really, really good first rotation, guys. Unfortunately, I can't keep the two coolers together. I would like to, but we have Golden Frieza. I can't take Golden Frieza out of rotation, right? So let's keep Golden Frieza in the first slot. Let's put the friend cooler in the middle. And should I pop an item? Do I need to? I don't think we need to pop an item, but what if we get supered like twice? Nah. What are the chances that's gonna happen? What are the chances that's gonna happen? Watch it happen now, though. I swear to God, it's gonna happen right now, just because I said that. Okay, so we're gonna go for Tien with the Fizz Cooler here. I think we might actually be able to kill Piccolo in the first turn. That'd be awesome. So we would only have to deal with two enemies after that, but we'll see what happens. We took a... took a super for basically no damage. That's what I love about Golden Frieza, man. He's so awesome. He's such an amazing tank, but still doing good damage at the same time. Like, that attack stat was, what, 2.2 million? So he's tanking like crazy, but still hitting, you know, surprisingly hard. So, yeah. Love Golden Cooler, or Golden Frieza. Man, I wish there was a Golden Cooler. Well, there is a Golden Cooler. No, the Dragon Ball Heroes one, but there needs to be, like, a proper Golden Cooler, you know, like a Dokkan Fest one. That is just like broken. Yo, if they release a Golden Cooler, it better be busted. Okay, so we didn't manage to kill anybody, but we did manage to almost kill Tien. So let's put Janemba here. I think right now we should item just in case the Cell takes a super. Actually, let's put Cell in the middle. Yeah, that's fine. We're gonna kill Piccolo here, and then we're gonna do an AoE attack here. And then let's try to kill Tien. Yeah, this should be a good turn. Should be a really, really good turn. So the way I see this cooler, the new cooler, is like he has two different forms. Well, obviously they are actual different forms, but in his like regular form, before he transforms, I see him as more of like a support unit, right? His function is more, you know, to support the rotation. Even though he can still hit pretty hard himself, he doesn't really become a monster until the transformation. And then once he transforms, he stops being a support unit and just becomes a freaking juggernaut, man. Like, crazy damage, crazy defense. Well, not crazy defense, good defense, but crazy damage. And hopefully we can get to see both of those modes today. But the thing is, in order for him to transform, you have to be facing a what was it? You have to be facing a Hybrid Saiyans or Pure Saiyans enemy. I mean, you don't have to, I guess, but it's a lot easier to get the transformation if you have those enemies. If not, then it's going to be, I think, six turns. You have to be on turn six or beyond to get the transformation. So that's kind of hard to do on Super Battle Road. It's still possible. But yeah, it could not happen in this video. So if that's the case, then, you know, that sucks. But he's still going to be very effective as a support unit. And he's going to make the other units on the rotation obviously hit a lot harder than they normally would without his support. So yeah, he's definitely still putting in work here. And this should about do it. I think our Janemba will kill Krillin now. We're going to move on. One item used, not too bad. I think if I tried really hard, you know, if I really focused on it, we could probably do a no item run with this team. But I don't feel like doing that today because it's just too much stress. You know, I'm just trying to enjoy my cooler right now. It's one of those rare times where I actually pull the unit that I want, as I said at the beginning of this video, in my first video, right? So I'm just going to enjoy it right now. And if I want to stress myself out later on, then maybe we'll try a no item run, you know, in the future. But for now, we're just going to take it easy, just try to beat this event. And that is like a whole lot of attacks. Holy crap, in the beginning, I don't really trust the cooler there, not gonna lie. Not because he's not a good tank, he can tank okay, but there's a lot of type advantage attacks, you know, there's a lot of AGL attacks there, so we're gonna put Golden Frieza there, just to be super safe, and I'm still gonna pop the Icarus, just because I'm scared of those attacks, so hopefully Golden Frieza can just kill 18. Even though I love 18, she's gotta go. All right, here we go. Oh, by the way, on a super unrelated note, it has nothing to do with the cooler, but I just started playing Seven Deadly Sins today, the new mobile game, Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross, and it is incredible, man. I actually put out a first impressions video. It ended up being, I think, like 50 minutes long. I was hoping to do 15 to 20 minutes of gameplay, but the tutorial just kept going and going, and I didn't want to skip any of the cutscenes. So yeah, I ended up doing like a 50-minute first impression video, and the game is just insane. Like, the animations are some of the best I've ever seen for a mobile game. The voice acting is amazing. The music is amazing. The gameplay mechanics seem really, really fun. Obviously, I still need to test it out more because I've only played pretty much past the tutorial and like the first two multis. So there's still a lot for me to learn about the game, but I gotta tell you, it's just so much fun right now. I don't remember the last time I've had so much fun with a new game, and definitely expect a lot more content on this channel for Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross, because I absolutely love it, guys. Like, no joke, it could potentially become my favorite mobile game of all time, right? And that's not to say I'm gonna quit Dokkan anytime soon, I'm not leaving the game, but it's just, I feel like I'm gonna be spending my time, or like splitting my time between Dokkan and Seven Deadly Sins going forward, if it does end up being as good as my initial impressions made it seem, because it just seems so good right now. It's like on the same level, honestly, like as far as the quality goes, I feel like it's on the same level as a lot of these like anime console games I've played, you know? Like, I don't think it's any worse than any of the Ultimate Ninja Storms or even like Kakarot. I mean, Kakarot's better, obviously. Okay, you know what? Maybe I'm going too far, but I'm just saying the quality is top notch. So great job to Netmarble for that game. If you guys haven't checked it out yet, maybe go see my first impressions video and decide for yourself if it's a game that you like. But I'm in love with it. I really am. Okay, so getting back to the gameplay, I keep getting distracted. Let's go for the AoE attack here. And we should kill 18 with Golden Frieza. And then these can go to cooler. Please don't super me. Thank you. Wow, we're tanking really, really well. And I don't think there's any items active either. I didn't realize that Fizz Cell could tank this well. Obviously, I knew the Incel was a great tank. But to tank that for double digits, damn. Obviously, it wasn't a super. A super would have hit really hard. But still, I didn't expect him to be able to take a regular attack for double digit damage without any items active. No items, right? Am I crazy? No, there's no items active. Okay, yeah, so that was really good. Good job to FizzCell. And this should about do it, my friends. Let's see. Yeah, so Janemba's a little bit better for us. Let's go for that. Then Janemba will finish the job if Cooler doesn't, but I'm pretty sure Cooler can. Let's do it, Cooler. Come on. Let's do it. Are there any Pure Saiyans or Hybrid Saiyans enemies at the end of this event? I don't remember. It's been too long. At the time, I was just focusing on not dying, you know, because the team was under a 130% lead. So I was like super, super scared that any super would kill me. So I don't think I was even paying attention to the enemies. So I'm not really sure. We'll see though. Second stage down. Final stage on the way. Oh, it's Gohan. Okay, so there's at least... Oh, right. It's just the Ultimate Gohan. I forgot about that. Okay, so this is going to be an issue. The Fizz... Cell and the Fizz Final Form Cooler, they're gonna get hit pretty hard. So should I go for a Ghost Usher or something else? Let's go for a Ghost Usher this turn, right? Or actually, I don't know if that's a good idea because I have the Golden Frieza tanking. Unless we can save the Dokkan attack until next turn. Yeah, we could do that. Wait, if I give him these, will that make him go over the edge? So let's go give him these. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we save the Dokkan attack. We're gonna save it for next turn. Are we gonna have a tankier rotation next turn though? Maybe not, but at the very least, we'll have a less type disadvantaged rotation. So I still think this is a good idea. I still think this was a good idea, but we'll see. We'll see. At the very least, we can get both Cooler transformations in two turns, right? So those crits will be very, very key. All right. So now let's put Janemba here. And I don't know, we should probably pop some things. Like let's pop and Princess Snake. And also, just to be super safe, let's also pop an Android 8. So we have extra defense and damage reduction. 151,000 defense for the friend Cooler. So now I think we'll be safe. The sad part is that we won't actually get any additional attack for the Janemba because he didn't get hit yet. So this is not going to do a ton of damage. And it's especially less effective because of the fact that it's just one Gohan, so we can't really benefit from attacking all the enemies. This is really annoying. I hate these stages on Super Battle Road where it's just one single enemy. It actually makes it a lot harder, especially when you have multiple units with type disadvantage. So at least we did okay damage there. It was about, what, 2 million that I saw? It wasn't too bad. We had the double support from the Coolers. That probably explains why the Janemba's attack was still pretty high. All right, moment of truth, guys. Moment of truth. How much is this going to do to us? 40. 21. Not bad. And then once the Cooler comes back on rotation, we can finally get the transformation. That's beautiful. Oh, this is going to hurt. Let's see it. Oh, 152k. You know, I've seen worse. All right, so what's gonna happen here is that most likely Gohan's gonna be a dick and super us in the middle. So just to, you know, not die from that, because that probably will kill us. I'm guessing that would do like 500k or something like that. We're gonna use a Princess Snake, all right? Defensively, everybody has high defense. Of course, Golden Frieza is not gonna take any defense any damage as always. So I'm not worried about him. Should I save these for the cell? I guess it doesn't matter too much. Cell's not gonna be hitting that hard anyways. Yeah, no, let's give these to Inth Cell. I was gonna originally save them for the Fizz Cell, but I'm like, Fizz Cell's not gonna do much damage unless he crits, which I don't really count on him to do. So yeah, we'll just let the Inth Cell super here. Otherwise, yo, I think we're gonna make it through. Especially once we get the transformation next turn. We're gonna be hitting really, really hard with the guaranteed criticals, the additional attacks, all that good stuff. So yeah, we'll do it, guys. We'll be okay. We'll be okay. Am I telling this to myself right now because I'm a little bit worried? Possibly. Maybe. I am a little bit worried, but not for, you know, the Golden Frieza or the Cell or anything like that, but mainly for the Fizz Cooler. That's the guy that really worries me right now. But he tanked really well there too. We still have the obviously defense from the Aider and the damage reduction from the Princess Snake. And here we go. We can get the transformation off now. Let's see it, guys. Let's see it. Oh my god. One of the most beautiful animations in the entire game, no question. I love it. I love it. Here we go. I should turn on the voice actually, but I'm too lazy to, like, you know, it's already muted. I don't want to turn it on again, so we're just gonna watch that with no voice line. But even so, it's still really, really good. So 109,000 defense now. I'm gonna pop another Aider just to give ourselves some more defense. And I'm actually gonna put Janemba at the end, so because there's a lot more attacks there. I think that's probably the best way to do this. Okay, yeah, so let's see what the cooler can do now. The final form cooler, post transformation, post active skill, 1.8 mil attack, and it's gonna be a guaranteed crit. So this should be some pretty good damage. Here we go, 1.2 mil. Additional, unfortunately, not an additional super. I think it's a medium chance, so about 25%. Okay, this is gonna be a good test of his tanking ability. Oh my goodness. 238. Okay. That's okay. That's okay. You know what? A lesser unit would have taken that for like 500,000. Like I said, like the Fizz Final Form Cooler probably would have taken that for just a ridiculous amount of damage. So I'm not worried right now. It's all good. Yo, let's get this double cooler going, man. Double final form cooler. And you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna Ghost Usher so that we don't have to worry about dying or anything like that. So yeah, second cooler transformation. And let's just try to end it this turn, because I think we are gonna use our last item. I think that Ghost Usher is our final item. I probably didn't have to use this many items for the run, but as you guys know, man, I like to play it safe. So all our items are used. This could be the last turn. I really hope it is. 2.37 mil linked with the Fizz Final Form Cooler. And let's get a double super and just kill him right here, right now. 1.5. Oh, damn. All right. No double super. Can we get a crit with the Fizz Cooler, please? No. Okay, you're gonna crit with the normal attack. Thank you. All right, great, perfect. And Golden Frieza, decent damage. This should do it, though. All right, this should be it. Yeah, you know, we're gonna be fine. We're gonna be fine. All right, guys. The Friend Final Form Cooler is going to take care of business. GG, Gohan. And that's gonna be the video. Yes? Come on. Let's do it. All right, 2.39 mil. And keep in mind, he does increase his attack with every super. So if he additional supers here, it should be even more than that. Ooh, okay, no additional super. Oh my god, don't super me, come on. Okay, we survived. It was a little bit scary at the end there. As you can see, man, like defensively, the cooler is still a leaves a little bit to be desired. He's not going to be the most amazing tank. He still has good defense. He still has good defense, but when you're facing an enemy like this, like, you know, the fights with the one enemy, they just hit like stupid hard. So I'm not surprised that he took this much damage. But of course, in that final fight against Gohan with those guaranteed crits, STR Cooler was still definitely the MVP damage wise. So there you go, guys. That is the transformation boost super battle stage cleared with my STR Cooler led team. And that's going to do it for the video. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day to click on this video as opposed to literally doing anything else with your time. And as always, if you liked the video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.